He is a man called to preach good news to the poor, heal the brokenhearted, proclaim liberty to those who are both in physical and spiritual prison, and declaring that the time of the Lord's favor has come. Join him every Sunday and experience divine visitation, total healing, and real deliverance through the power of prayer and the spoken word.
I've seen believers that have been born again for 20 years, they don't have a child.
For the Lord shall deliver thee from every evil work.
I have chosen to release you from this wicked chain of injustice.
And your life will never be the same again.
There's a champion inside you. There's something special inside you. You have ability to prosper.
Failure is not your portion. You will never fail in life.
The author of several books, including Freedom from Evil Foundation, Destroying Destiny Destroyers, Silencing the Voice of Evil Sacrifices, Eliminating Satanic Obstructions, and much more. Join him in one of our services for counseling, prayer, and personal ministration right here on this station.
Call or visit www.domlive.org.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, my dear viewer, this is the Hour of Deliverance. My prayer is that God will touch you, God will bless you, God empower you. I'm here once more with Pastor Jonathan from House of God Ministry in London here. We're going to agree with you and pray for you. When one chase 1,000, two chase 10,000, then we are three. We are going to clear the way for you to prosper in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, we thank you in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Let your word be quick.
Thank you, Lord.
Let your word be powerful.
Thank you, Lord.
This woman, that is her hope is gone.
Mm.
Give her an answer.
Amen.
This young man, this man that wants to commit suicide, give him an answer.
Amen.
Show to this generation you are still the same Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Who defeated Satan, who defeated hell. Who triumphant and disgrace them in their own domain.
Amen.
Show yourself to our generation.
Amen.
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 God bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As I was saying to you the other day, I have these four powerful books here. I want you to agree with us and take it. It will help you. And God will bless you in Jesus' name. If you support our ministry, £20 or more, I will send you these four books and God will bless you in Jesus' name. Please. Amen. Let something touch your heart. And anytime you see me on any of our TV, take your telephone, call me on this number, 0207-923-2549-724-8804, and send me only text message on my beautiful phone here, 0795070-1853. We've been talking about a powerful topic here, tragedy of spiritual blockage.
Mm-hmm.
Tragedy of spiritual blockage. Something that block you that you can't even see it. You know that you are being blocked in life. You want to advance, you can't. You want to marry, you can't. You want to have a baby, you can't. The doctor said there's nothing wrong with you, but you can't. Why am I being stopped? You don't know it. That's why Paul was confused. In First Corinthians chapter 16 verse 9, he said a great door, an effectual door, is open unto me, but there are many adversaries. That adversary was not physical adversary.
That's right.
That's why he explained it very well in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 18 and 19. He said, we wanted to come. We couldn't. Again, we couldn't. And I said, maybe there's bad luck on you. Let me, the Apostle General, try it. He said, again and again, but Satan hinder me.
That's right.
I don't know what is hindering your life. I am here to pray for you. That thing that hinder you, God will take it away in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Your life will be peace.
Amen.
Your life will be peace.
Amen.
Your life will be peace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Please, Pastor Joe, let's read from where we read the other time. Isaiah chapter 57, the verse 14. Isaiah 57, the verse 14.
And one shall say, heap it up, heap it up. Prepare the way. Take the stumbling block out of the way of my people.
Did you hear that? Take the stumbling block
out of the way of
that
my people.
See, one of the quotations I love so much is Psalm 91. If you read to the verse 11 and 12, he said, God will make his angel to hold us in their hands. Yeah, so lest at any time we dash our feet against a stone. Who put the stone there? The stone is the Sammy block.
Right.
The very next verse is that the lion, the adder, the great dragon.
Mm-hmm.
So the lion, the adder, the great dragon were satanic symbolism of Satan putting that stone to make you fall.
Yes. It's true.
That's why the Bible said the righteous fall seven times.
Yes.
See, I don't want to follow because there are certain fall. If you fall, you can't rise up.
You can't rise up again.
I pray for you. Any stumbling block, any demonic blockage, blocking you from marrying, blocking your womb from having babies, blocking your business, making you to work without nothing, making you to go through sickness. By the blood of Jesus,
amen.
It is canceled forever.
It is canceled, amen.
There's one quotation I want us to read quickly. In the book of Genesis, let's see this blockage here. And then I'm going to give you Genesis chapter 48. 48. Look at the verse 13. See, one of the areas you know that spiritual blockage is available is your own family. Who will block you?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it from the family?
That's right.
Yes. He said,
and
what?
Joseph took them both.
Mm-hmm.
Ephraim with his right hand.
Mm-hmm.
Toward Israel's left hand.
Yes.
And Manasseh with his left hand.
Yes.
Towards Israel's right hand.
Yes.
And brought them near him.
Yes.
Then Israel stretched out his right hand.
Yes.
And laid it on Ephraim's head.
Yes.
Who was the younger.
Yes.
And his left hand on Manasseh's head.
Yes.
Guiding his hands knowingly.
Yes.
For Manasseh was his firstborn.
Yes.
And he blessed Joseph and said,
mm-hmm.
God, before whom my father Abraham now, and Isaac walked.
Jump to verse 17.
And now, and when Joseph saw that his father laid his hand, his right hand, on the head of Ephraim, it displeased him. So he took hold of his father's hand to remove it from Ephraim's head to Manasseh's head. And Joseph said to his father, not so, my father, for this one is the firstborn. Put your right hand on his head. But his father refused and said, I know, my son.
Now, did you hear that, Pastor Joe? Is it by force for the firstborn to be blessed before the secondborn? Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
It is, see, the fact that you are older than me does not mean that you must be greater than me. It is God that made great.
That's right.
It is God that give favor.
Mm-hmm.
But here, Joseph knows that the father carry some prophetic words,
right.
That every word the father will speak will come to pass. And Joseph was trying physically to block Ephraim from blessing.
From,
he was trying to remove, obstructing the father, confusing the father. Because when he was coming, he prophetically, your right hand is here, your left hand is here.
Yes.
So he prophetically brought the firstborn here so that the right hand, so, because Bible talk about who is the right hand of God. He's Jesus. Jesus is sitting at the right hand side of God. Because if you read the Bible, Bible talk about right hand, right hand, right hand, right hand, right hand, right hand. Even he said the sheep are on the right hand, the goats are on the left hand. He said they put Jesus on the right hand, they put Barabbas on the left hand. And the people said, kill Jesus. On the right hand is the power.
That's right.
In the book of Obadiah, he said, out of his right hand come of power.
That's
in the book of Habakkuk, he repeated the same thing verbatim. Now, when the father knows, they know the father was blind. But spiritual realm, God is showing us that the fact that you are older than me does not mean that you should be greater than me. It is God that gives grace.
That's right.
In my language, they have a proverb that
Obikran
yami no bi nyinaho. When God was sending us, nobody was there. So it is God that blessed.
That's right.
So the father crossed the hand, knowing that what this is what Joseph has done. And Joseph wanted to obstruct the blessing.
That's right.
I pray for you.
In the name of Jesus.
I don't know who wants to obstruct your blessing.
Oh, yes, Lord.
But God is changing the blessing back in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
So if whether you're second born or third born, what is the reason of blocking me? But physically, see, when Joseph saw, he was physically obstructing the blessing.
Yes.
Now, what of the spiritual one? This is what we are talking about. Mm-hmm. Physically, if I know that this is it, Joseph know that this is where I want, mm-hmm. and program this what he wants. Mm-hmm. But spiritually, when something was blocking you, I said to you the other day that to be blocked means to be obstructed.
Yeah.
To be blocked means to be hindered.
Yeah.
To be blocked means to be stagnated. Mm. It's like you are driving a car, and police has put a barrier there. Mm-hmm. You see traffic.
That's right.
You're supposed to, the road that you're supposed to use 1 hour, you can use 5 hours, mm-hmm. 4 hours, 3 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Because the road is what? Blocked.
Yeah.
When the road is blocked in life, you are delayed.
Mm.
And one thing I want to tell you is that there are effects of this spiritual blockage.
Mm.
There are effects. Let me show you this quotation quickly before I show you the effect of spiritual blockage. In the book of 1 Kings chapter 5. Look at verse 2, sir.
Okay. Then Solomon sent to Hiram, saying,
Yes.
You know how my father David could not build a house for the name of the Lord his God.
Yes.
Because of the wars which were fought against him on every side.
See, everywhere the man is looking for is blocked.
Yes.
Forward block, center block, back block. Keep going, sir.
Until the Lord put his foes under the sole of his feet.
Yes.
But now, the Lord my God has given me rest on every side. There is neither adversary nor evil occurrence.
So that means this is what blocked David.
That's right.
Evil occurrence and adversary.
Yes.
David said, on every side, my father have wars.
That's right.
So this wars was not physical wars. It was spiritual wars. If you don't understand spiritual things, you think that it was physical wars. But there was a spirit behind what he was going through.
That's right.
You see Absalom rise up against him. You see Ammon rape the child.
That's right.
You see Absalom kill Ammon. You see Ahithophel gang up with Absalom to overthrow him.
Yeah.
You see Joab and the brother was good. It's what from you see Bathsheba also pregnant for him. Yeah. You see he killed, but it's like one problem to another problem to another problem to another problem. My father have wars on every side.
That's right.
The power behind this is what? The adversary.
That's right.
And the evil occurrence. It block him, make sure he can't do whatever he wants to do. And it has effect on man. Number one, I want to give you this thing quickly before I pray for you. Please, there's a number on your screen there. Take the number quickly and call me. Let me pray for you. Send me your text message on my mobile phone and I want to pray for you quickly. The mobile phone I want you to call is 079. Send me text message is 079-50-701-853. The man said, my father have wars, but I have rest.
That's right.
I listen to you. My father have wars, but I have rest. What brought the rest? Because he said, my father conquered the adversary. What is an adversary? An opponent.
Right.
Somebody that stop on your way.
That's
somebody that makes sure you can't advance in life.
Right.
Somebody that stop you. The adversary is like Manchester United playing football with Arsenal.
That's right.
That's why you see defense,
yes.
You see goalkeeper, you see midfield.
Right.
What is their purpose? Their purpose is to make sure you can't score them.
That's right.
Their goals in life is available, but there are certain adversaries that has been programmed to block you.
That's right.
People get injured in trying to score goals. Somebody leg break in trying to score goals. It's part of the process. I want to score. There's so many money, there's so much money involved in scoring the goal of life. So many destiny is at stake. People has gambled. People's life is at stake. So if you mess up, I think one of the World Cup, somebody got angry and shot somebody after the World Cup. One of the Colombians' boys.
Yes, yes.
They shot him and killed him.
That's right.
A man got angry, carry his TV, throw it out.
Mm.
I think when France beat Brazil, carry his television, throw it out.
As if it is the television that is causing the problem.
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
People's destinies are at stake.
Pastor, just let me dwell here a little bit. I just want us to look the way Solomon looked at things.
Yes, sir.
The adversaries and the evil occurrence.
Yes, sir.
Did not allow David to do what was in his heart. But now the adversaries are outside.
Yes,
I am able to do.
Yes, sir.
So with life, when adversaries are there,
yes,
you find it difficult to do what you want to
because
do.
Because they are there until, to stop you.
Until they are out of the you. Way before you'll be able to achieve what you want to achieve.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. That's
in
very
terms
important.
Of money, David had it to build.
Yes, sir.
But the adversaries did not allow him. So see, now with Solomon, adversaries out of his way, he's able to do it.
That's what we are talking about. Spiritual mm-hmm. blockage
that's right.
happened to an aspect of your life.
That's right.
The totality of your being is fine.
Mm.
You have married.
That's right.
You're a beautiful woman.
Yes.
You're a handsome man.
Yes.
But they say you have low sperm count.
Yes.
It affects you.
It affects
your wife. The totality of your being.
That's right. Yes.
You have money.
Yes.
You have a good job.
Yes.
But they say you have low sperm
yes.
count.
Mm.
You're a beautiful woman.
Yes.
You have money.
Yeah.
You have good husband.
Mm-hmm.
You have everything.
Yes.
But they said your womb is blocked.
Mm.
You have clever, a mm. young girl, have clever everything, but they don't want to give her papers.
Mm.
See, an aspect of your that's
yes.
why you are saying
mm.
David have money.
Yes.
David is a king.
Yes.
David, everything about David was mm-hmm. fine.
But he could not do what
he
was in his
do
heart.
What was in his heart.
Mm. Right.
Thank God he defeated enemy. That's what we are talking.
Mm-hmm.
See, as a mother, mm-hmm. don't let your daughter went yeah. through what you went mm-hmm. through.
Yeah. And
as
if
a
you
father,
don't defeat that enemy, your yeah, children
your
will come
children,
and fight
that's
that
the thing.
That is the area I wanted to come to.
Yes.
The things that you don't conquer,
yes, sir.
Your children will come
it
and
will
fight
you. Conquer
it.
You.
So if David had died without conquering them, Solomon too would have come into battle fighting
Abba the battle. Baba
you know, so now opportunity has now been availed.
Mm.
I can do what I want to do.
Mm.
So also in life,
mm.
you know, when opportunity avail,
mm.
Pastor, everybody can buy TV.
Mm.
Now, let somebody give you 10 million. Whether you won't open a TV station
oh, yes,
bigger.
Sir. Yes,
you
sir.
See, everybody can do good things.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But the opportunity doesn't come.
It's true. It's
there
true.
Is nobody who gets the opportunity can do good things.
Yes, sir. Yes,
I
sir.
Can be a prime minister. I will have elders
mm-hmm.
there helping me to do things.
Mm-hmm.
But how to get there is the issue
that's
now.
It.
Unless
that's
you overcome the adversary
the
and
adversary,
the evil occurrence.
The adversary.
Yes, you
the
can't go forward.
The adversary are the powers that block man.
That's right.
The evil occurrence.
That's right.
How do you explain this?
Yes.
Thing? Somebody have 17 miscarriages.
Hmm.
Evil occurrence.
Evil occurrence.
How do you explain this thing? Somebody have 5 children.
Hmm.
All of them died.
Hmm.
Evil occurrence.
Hmm.
Listen to me. I want to give you 7 quickly because we want to go for a quick break and then we are going to come.
Hmm.
Number one, whenever you are going through intensive marital problems,
mm-hmm.
you know that there is a blockage that it wants to block you from marrying.
Hmm.
You don't talk to your wife. You don't talk to your husband.
Mm.
You are living in the same room.
Mm.
Marital turbulence.
Mm.
When I talk about marital turbulence, it involves all the totality of your marriage.
Mm.
Your children are part of your marriage.
Yes.
Your whole body is part of the marriage.
Oh, yes.
Today you are sick.
Mm.
Tomorrow your husband is sick.
Mm.
You can't have a baby.
Mm.
You had a baby. Your baby is sick.
Mm.
It's like, why can't I have peace in my marriage?
That's right.
Number two, you go through chains of problems.
Mm.
Chains of problems. Migration problem stop your job. You lose your job.
Mm-hmm.
Your job problem was solved. Your child is sick. Your child problem stop. They sack you.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you don't have rest.
That's right.
He said, my father have wars on every side of his life.
Mm.
Until a man have rest, you can't go forward in life.
Mm.
To succeed in life, you need rest.
Mm.
You need rest.
Mm.
It's the ministry that we are doing. If the ministry don't have rest from gossiping, by biting,
and
frustration,
mm.
you can't go forward.
You can't,
the
true.
Time you, the pastor, is supposed to pray,
yes.
you have to sit
certain
people down
cases,
and talk.
That's right.
Certain mm. cases. I want to pray for you.
Mm.
Listen to me. One of the evidence of, one of the effects of this spiritual blockage is nightmares in your dreams.
Mm.
You see yourself being present in the dream. You see so many effects in your dream. Please, I want you to call me quickly. I have very small time here. I want you to call the number quickly. I want to pray for you.
Mm.
Maybe you are going through nightmares. You dream, you see somebody injecting you. Last week, I was preaching on our radio.
Mm-hmm.
We have an internet radio on our website. You can locate it. We have internet TV on our website. You can go www.domlife. If you go to the apps now, you can even have the apps. We have the apps there that you can even have it. It's very, very important. You can see it preaching there. It's so quick. We have the TV, we have the radio, the apps. You go ACTS Television, Arise Christian Television Service, is on the apps. You can download it and use it 24 hours. It will help you. Sorry. Sorry. See, get this thing. I want to talk with you. Last time we were discussing, and Pastor Jonathan said something that in life, God has created people in every side you are looking for. Okay. If you have problem with your eye, you go to eye specialist. We have the brain one.
Yes.
We have even hair. People that now, they planted hair.
That's right.
We have the ears. We have the teeth. We have the nose, sinus. We have the bones.
Yes.
People that are specialists on the bones. We have the gynecologist.
That's right.
People that are specialists on the womb.
That's right.
We have the knee.
Yes.
People that are specialists on the knee. We have the chiropodist. People that are specialists on the nails
and
all those things. So also in ministry, we have people that are specialists in every kind.
Yes.
They brought a boy that was mad from all the way from Leeds. All the members of our church were there. Within 2 weeks, the boy was totally well. They brought another girl, South African girl, who was mentally derailed, completely mad. The mother brought her in our church. Within shortest time, bam, everything was fine. See, don't sit down and die. There's hope for you. We have so many text messages, we can't read it here. The time is very quick.
That's right.
Coming just on the TV for quick time. But take time. Come, let us sit down. On every Tuesdays, on every Wednesdays, on every Friday, we sit down and talk with people.
That's right.
Diagnose you. We have a form that next time when I'm coming, I'll bring the form. It's about 5 sheets. We go through your root, your background, your dreams to diagnose where the thing is coming from. And we pray effective prayer for you to locate it, to make sure that your life moves forward. You understand what I'm saying? See, if you don't know what is blocking you, you can't remove it.
You can't remove it. How will you know?
One day, I was teaching my son, little boy, I bought a cycle. I put a tripod, and he was riding. And when he got confident on it, I removed the tripod. And there was a particular stone that was there because I was teaching him on the cemetery. The cemetery is the close place near to us that it is calm. There's no car there.
That's right.
And the boy go run. And when he got to the stone, he just
loses his balance.
He lose the balance and he just fell. And he continued. And suddenly I said to him that, boy, remove the stone. And he tried to remove it. He can't. I said, why don't you use all your strength? And he tried. Whoa! I said, boy, use all your strength. He tried again. I repeated again. Suddenly he broke down crying. Daddy, don't you know I'm using all my strength? Physically, he was using his strength. And you can see the boy is breaking his back. So I just went there, used only my left hand, one hand, and remove it. I said, your strength is me.
That's
he said, oh, is that what you mean? I didn't know that. I threw it away. And he just, listen to me. God has made men. He said he has given us apostles, pastors, evangelists, prophets, for the perfecting of the church.
That's right.
And people are sitting there dying. Please, come, let us reason together. Amen. We are going for a quick break now. Pastor Joe, give your telephone number before
my telephone we go number for break now. Will appear on the screen now. 07-969 553-0068.
Please
07-969-553-0068.
And please show them
House of God Ministry. We are in Feltham, West London, closer to Heathrow. Our Sunday service is from 3 o'clock to 6. Please, worship, prayer. We don't go to church without prayer.
Hallelujah.
Because that is the weapon, the sword of the spirit.
Yes, sir.
You know. And so please, whatever your situation is, as he said, sometimes it takes somebody to remove that stone.
Yes,
which
sir.
You cannot remove.
Yes, sir.
And sometimes you are in an awkward situation somebody has to remove the stone from you.
Yes,
so
sir.
Don't sit there and suffer. Whatever the situation, don't go round and round and round thinking it will be okay. That's why God has placed different ministry to help his body. Please don't sit there and suffer. If it is an area of deliverance, please call and God will take you through.
Hallelujah. Listen to me. May God bless you in Jesus' name. We are talking about satanic obstruction. We are going to go to a quick break and come. Many people are going through pain. And when we come back, I'm going to renounce it with you. We are going to pray heavily. One of the effects of this satanic blockage or spiritual blockage is delayance in life. You can't do what you want to do. You try it and try it and try it and try it. See, when I was going around that McDonald's, I was sharing the testimony. Instead of me to use just 5 minutes, for about 25 minutes, I was standing there, going around and around and around in life. Many people's life are being delayed. You see something I put there, you go through terrible dreams, nightmares in dreams. You see something I call all run failure. Because you are being blocked spiritually. You know you can get, all your focus is one side. Like you said the other day when we came, that when the obstruction is removed, you can do what your fathers couldn't
That's
do.
That's right.
When Samson killed the lion, the next day they were coming, there was no lion.
There was calm on the road.
Every place was peace. See, until that blockage is removed, you can't go. That's why the Bible says, the angel of the Lord will hold you in their hands. Satan has put a stumbling block, a stone in front of you to make you crumble, to make you fall, to paralyze you. Bible said there was a man called Mephibosheth. When the nurse was run away, the nurse tripped and the nurse fell. And the baby was what? Crippled.
That's right.
And was relegated to Lodibar.
That's right.
I pray for you.
In the name of Jesus.
Anything that has crippled you, anything that has paralyzed you, anything that has limited your life, by the blood of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I release you right now. In the name of Jesus. That's here the Lord. I declare you are free. Your marriage is free. Your children, they are free. Your destiny is free. Your business will explode. You are moving forward. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
You understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
Don't call my number now. Just send me the text message. And please take my telephone number as I'm going to this quick break. I'm coming back. And then we're going to pray for you in Jesus' name. My number is 0207-923-2549-724-8804. If you want to send me something to help our ministry in coming to the TV, I'll give you these three books about the dreams. These three books about the altars plus the dream book. I will mail it to you as quickly as possible. Your life will never be the same again. May God impact something in you. May God bless you. Let God talk to you. Let God talk to you. Let something enter you. Help us, and God will bless you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. May God empower you. May God bless you. May God lift you on high. Please don't go anywhere. Stay there, and something is going to happen to you. We thank the Lord for your life. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Be empowered.
Be empowered.
Be lifted.
Amen.
Generation unborn will hear you.
Amen.
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 God bless you.
God bless
Bye-bye.
You. Bye.
He is a man called to preach good news to the poor, heal the brokenhearted, proclaim liberty to those who are both in physical and spiritual prison, and declaring that the time of the Lord's favor has come. Join him every Sunday and experience divine visitation, total healing, and real deliverance through the power of prayer and the spoken word.
I've seen believers that have been born again for 20 years, they don't have a child.
For the Lord shall deliver thee from every evil work.
I've chosen to release you from this wicked chain of injustice.
And your life will never be the same again.
There's a champion inside you. There's something special inside you. You have ability to prosper.
Failure is not your portion. You will never fail in life.
The author of several books, including Freedom from Evil Foundation, Destroying Destiny Destroyers, Silencing the Voice of Evil Sacrifices, Eliminating Satanic Obstructions, and much more. Join him in one of our services for counseling, prayer, and personal ministration right here on this station. Call or visit www.domlive.org.